today I'm going to be making that bright and vibrant card that you see in the beginning of the video. It is, it uses Pretty Line Florals, which is this really beautiful stamp that I have. But on top of that, we're going to be using Allodyne Dye, IZINK Dye Sprays. These were developed by Seth Apter, who is an amazing artist. And Allodyne has teamed up with him to create these beautiful sprays. Now, I've been playing with these sprays a lot, and I've realized a few things. First of all, in my make and takes at shows, we use manila tags for our make and takes because I know that these sprays work really well on heavy card stock, or heavy stock. If you have a chance and you really love these, you can either work on really heavy card stock, 110 card stock, or 100 pound card stock, and smooth but not glossy card stock works really well, or run out and get yourself some Ink Essentials by Rangers. This is manila cardstock, 8 by 8.5 by 11. Comes with a free manila tag, but you get 10 pieces. So I'm going to show you these sprays and what makes them so special. I'm actually working on my surface, but I'm going to cover it today with this paper towel, so I don't necessarily have to clean up every time I spray. So I'm just going to put that down and I'm just going to spray randomly with a couple of colors. Okay, so first we're going to be using the Wild Rose, and the names are down here, or Rose Cerise. This one, these are dye spray. You don't necessarily have to shake these because, as you can see, it's really well mixed. There's no dye at the bottom. So you can just literally lift these off and do some spraying. So I am spraying very close to the cardstock. I'm practically on top of it when I spray. The second color I'm using is lavender. And this is a nice deep color that I thought would go really well with pink. And I'm just gonna put some on here. And then I'm going to do something a little different, as it's really covered in two colors, is I am going to take a spray of licorice, which is the black, and just give that a quick little spritz. Just to get some interest in there. And then finally, I'm going to be using this spray, which is bronze. A little bit about the bronze, the gold, the pearl, and the copper. They are not technically, Allodyne doesn't consider them sprays in the shiny line, which is their shimmering one. But this has a lot of shimmer in it. So if you can see this, Allodyne calls these no clog sprays, but I have found that these shimmer ones, because there's so much shimmer on the bottom of these, I found that it clogged a couple of times. So, and I just ran the nozzle through very hot water and it came out. It is a very good nozzle, spoken from somebody who dealt with a lot of nozzle issues over the years with the Shimmering Bliss. It is a really good nozzle on it. So I am just going to add some pockets of color to this. I want to get really close to the cardstock with this one because I want three little areas where it's really heavy duty there. So I don't know if you can see how pretty that is. I might actually, I'm going to dry this and then see if I would like to add any additional colors to it. It is pretty colorful. I would recommend you dry this before you go on to the next step. Well, you have to dry it before you go on to the next step because we are going to be doing some embossing. So let me dry this quickly with my heat tool and come right back to you. Okay, so now my piece is nice and dry, and then I just ran my anti-static bag over it. And I've just lined up the Pretty Line Floral stamp on my stamp positioner. I am going to use some gold and gold embossing powder, and I'm going to put gold over the top of this. So I've stamped that in gold, and I'm going to add some gold embossing powder to this. So I've covered the piece with gold embossing powder, and now I'm going to just heat it and emboss it. I'll come right back to you. All right, so there is my piece. It is sprayed and embossed. It's actually really beautiful in person. It's got a lot of color variations. I'm not sure the camera is picking up. So now to finish this, I'm just going to add a little bit of black spray I'm going to spray from higher up because I don't want it everywhere. I just want to add a little personality to it. And I'll dry that. And that is my piece. I am just going to cut this down and add my sentiment to it. And I have this beautiful, beautiful, deeply colored, interesting looking background. If you want to add even more interest, you can add water spritzes to it. It'll change it a little bit. Let that air dry. That'll change it a little bit, brighten it up, pick up some of the color. I'm going to let that air dry, and then I'm going to put my sentiment on there, and this card will be done. All right, to finish this card, I did a couple of things. First of all, I backed this. I cut it down, and I backed it on a piece of black cardstock, and then that will go on a white card. I added some texture to this black piece of cardstock here, just a little bit of texture to add some interest to it. So I'm going to put that down pretty much in the center of the card there. I will trim off those edges. Made it a little bigger than I needed it. So I'm just going to place that down. And then what I did was I stamped Get Well Soon here, and I created a little extra piece. You can see the remainder here of the sprayed background because I wanted to add another flower here just over the top because I thought it would be more interesting. So I'm going to be putting the Get Well Soon on here, and you can see this is going to overhang a little bit too. I'll be cutting those down at the same time and then putting this over the top. So I've tacked that down, and I'm going to be putting the flower over here and trying to keep that pretty much on there. Now I'm just going to gently take and put some black gems in the center of those flowers that were done before. So there's our card mounted on white cardstock. As you can see, it makes a beautiful Get Well card. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial today. If you did, please give us a thumbs up on YouTube and consider subscribing to the Technique Junkies channel. I'll see you next time. Bye now.